Hello and welcome back to Pathologic Classic HD. Day 2 of Clara's game begins. So, as always, I'm going to use a little bit of my foreknowledge of the game to predict a little bit of where I need to go. So today we are going to go past Lara Rebel's house. We're going to make this kind of arcing journey past Lara's to Katharina and Alexander and then down. I didn't actually have enough. Anyway. Right. Nope. One good thing about Clara's game is that she has no need for ammunition. I haven't learned how to do this yet. Nope, you see me. However, the fact that I can just go killing people without really having to worry too much about the cost of ammunition and the cost of repairing the guns and using the guns does certainly make Clara's path an easier one in many ways, but, well, easier to be bloodthirsty at least, which sometimes helps in this game.
Ruspex was offered 100,000 for his inheritance. He refused.
Never seen you here before. Who have you come to visit? You, I suppose. You are Lara Revel, right?
Dogs are howling. Why?
So you've come because you found out we're setting up a shelter. Do you want to take part? It's strictly private, though, and I've never seen you before.
Why? I do want to take part. Do I have to donate some money?
No, you can't. The Harpist wouldn't let me. I have a rule. No one has refused hospitality at my house if they're an honest and honorable person. But the Harpist says we can't abide by this rule in a time of epidemic, or else our undertaking will be pointless.
Who is this Harpist?
Harpist is a friend. Just a friend, nothing more. It's not like he gives me orders, but this time I'm trusting his judgment. He's practical, strong-willed, and resolute. I'm a bit of a gawk, and I don't have a lot of guts either. That's why I listened to him on this.
I'd like to help you too, but I'm not what you'd call practical.
I'm not prepared to put you in charge of supplies for the House of the Living, but there is a way that you can help. The Harpist has gone off to look at an empty house, and he hasn't come back yet. If he's still there, tell him to come back here as soon as possible. I can't keep up without him.
Just that? Your trust seems easy to earn.
Not as easy as all that. If you do a good deed seeking no gain, it will at least be clear that you are not the Shabnakadir. A demon cannot do good. Then I'll be able to rely on you instead of the Bachelor, who I dislike. I feel that he'll do with that money as he sees fit. We're less than human as far as he's concerned.
Won't that make him cross with me?
It's up to you. Either you want to become a keeper of the House of the Living, or you don't. I can't spend money anyway without the Harpist approval.
Fine, I'll find this Harpist of yours.
Well, if you remember from the Horrorspexes and Bachelor scenarios, we already know how this particular story ends. Well, that could have gone better. Could have gone worse, but could have gone better.
So, once more, I apologize for the long delay between uploads of videos. Every so often I do have a set of real-life circumstances that prevents me from doing things quite as quickly as I would have otherwise of late. And in this case it was multiple night shifts, then exams, then job interviews. Which was less than ideal.
Time. That's not Turin. Nah, oh well. At least one positive thing from all this is that my reputation will be restored from killing all these bandits, but once more, reputation is clearly bloodthirsty work. Right. I'm just going to see if the quest of the day is open yet.
I've got a firm hand.
I spent the night in thought and recollection, trying to trace the logic of the supernatural retribution that has befallen our community. It has been revealed to my wife that there is a creature among us who is to blame for all this happening. I've gone through a list of possible suspects I have here in front of me. Every one of these people could turn out to be the criminal, the one that brought this disaster down upon us. How did you pick these people? For years, I've been keeping order in this town and looking for possible criminals. I trust my clairvoyant wife's judgment. Even that trust, however, I would have thought unduly partial, but seeing my hypothesis confirmed for rival mistresses. So what do you expect from me? I only want one thing, and that's it. Justice. This is a case where we can dispense with evidence and trials. When the last dawn is rising above the world, the time for arguments is of a different nature. A trial resting on conscience and a verdict resting on faith. Find the culprit for us. That's why you've come into this world and into our house and into this town's rules. But how am I supposed to do it, Father? I can call you that now, right? Well, first of all, you must gain the trust of the person I believe to be the criminal responsible for this. Anyone would find the task complicated and demanding except for you, since all you have to do is predict the slightest movement of their soul. Do something for them, raise their spirits, astonish them. Surely you can. There's no need to go over all that. I explained it to you myself, after all. And then? Yes. You will lull them with your words, men make them answer your questions, and see if they are guilty. My wife is positive that if you are first to win a person's favorable disposition and then astonish them, you will succeed. They will not be able to avoid your thrall, for you are destiny. That is true. Sometimes the precision of your definition scares me, Father. I will trust you.
All I want to know is who brought the deadly disease upon our homes and heads. Even the basket of scoundrels will suffer nothing at my hands if they are not guilty of our present predicament. Who should I begin with? A mysterious creature named Aspity will, I am sure, be the best start. Children say that she is an evil spirit. Simon didn't like her. That bitch has been called a walking plague even before this. I'm sure that a woman, a man-eater, and a spawn of the steppe, which is exactly what a Shabnak is a fitting description for her. How do I make her reveal herself after I've gained her trust? Who can tell me something about her that she'd be surprised to hear? Right. You don't know anyone here. The shortest way is via the old Gimskis. Ask Vlad the Younger, old Gimski's son. The old Gimskis must have old scores to settle with her. Besides, Vlad the Younger is knowledgeable about the legends and the traditions of the steppe people. He will instruct you. Yes, father, I'll do my duty. Oh, goodness, sorry, I think my voice acting, or at least narration talents, are slightly failing today. Oh, before I leave, Katarina's probably got something to say as well. Goodness. Oh.
My girl.
Now I shall speak to you of the higher causes of the unfolding disaster. Like roots, they are invisible to the eye. When one plucks a weed, one merely removes the consequence, not the underlying cause. You are the only one capable of a true victory, and that is why I am going to tell you about the roots. So listen. I'm listening. These are our parties. The first thing, the original creation, was the Earth, the Ancient One, giving life to plants and animals. She begat the abattoir. She begat the kin. She gives and she takes. The dead go into her. Everything ends with her. She is the inception and the completion. Such is the law. We, the Sabarovs, act in the interests of the law, which by everyone must abide. Ours is a faith of humility. A wise faith. A town sprang up upon the earth. A town of men was built upon her, the earth eternal, the giver of life, built by greed and creativity, by ingenuity and hard work. The abattoir formed its continuation in the works and the railways. The hands of the Olginskis crafted an environment in which people could develop and reflect. Theirs is a faith of the construction. A necessary faith. Finally, the minds of people desiring to overcome the limits set for human beings by their nature and condition engendered projects that were fantastic and audacious. That was how the party of creativity and invention emerged and flourished, the party of the kings. Theirs is a faith of utopia, a belief in miracles, a belief in a non-existent place. A weird faith. I foresee myself knowing why the punishments have befallen us. The town lived, grew, developed, and finally tried to break free of its own limitations. The earth that had borne it hit it on its head, which it had stuck out too far, much like a strict mother would do to her unthinking child. So this is the will of the earth? I believe that the earth wishes to return unto herself what has moved waywardly out of her reach. And before I explain to you the path that I am setting before you, I want to know for certain whether I have my dear child on my side. Yes, Katarina, I believe that our faith is the true one. You will speak to those bound you know about the truth of humility. You are to convince one of them, two of them, three of them of the true faith's wisdom. Should some of them prove stubborn, you will use the powers that were granted to you by the Providence itself. What happens to them afterwards, if I do convert them? The evil will not touch them. You will see it for yourself. They will become invulnerable to the scythe that will cut down the brazen, the blind, and the bellicose. Save them. All right. You will begin with Grace, the late cemetery caretaker's daughter. She is especially dear to me. But Grace, doesn't she sympathize with you, with us? I want to be certain of that. Make friends with her, try to make her like you and grow an affection for you generally. You don't need much for this, and all you need to find out more about her, Lara Revelle is the person who will tell you all about Grace. She is as much of an angel of kindness as the poor daughter of the caretaker, and her father has recently died too. I trust you, Katarina. What you're saying is wise and true. Well, back to Lara Revelle then. Hmm. let's just see if there's perhaps a quicker way of going about this. So, we do need to talk to younger Vlad as well.
Yeah, it's fine. So, the hooks that lead into people's souls can be gathered from other people's souls. I suppose that implies something about the interconnectedness of the world. Well, my reputation is pretty high now, so that's something. Oh, goodness.
It's nice to see you.
Lara, tell me about Grace. You know her, don't you? What makes you think I do? You're similar. You both live for the sake of the dead. Or am I wrong? You're probably right. But if you're so sharp and observant, why don't you talk to Grace herself? I'd feel rather awkward. I barely know Grace. We haven't spoken a lot. Do you want to make friends with her? Of course I do. If you want to make a good impression on Grace, bring her some flowers, bread, and milk for the dead. She'll be elated and do anything for you. That's simple. And what do I give Grace for herself? She doesn't need anything. With people like Grace and me, it's the good done to one's neighbor that matters. Thought you understood that. I do. It's called selflessness. Well, that makes things a little bit easier. Oh shit.
Whoa.
Ah! Ouch. Ouch. That really fucking hurt. Oof, jeez. I don't think I've got enough water bottles to trade for more bandages. Do I? No, I don't. I've barely got any. I need to get more. And of course the bins are empty now. Jeez. This certainly has made fights a lot easier, must be said. Right. Let's go around to get inside. Ugh. Unfortunately, one of the keys on my keyboard is slightly sticky. Which is making my character slightly wander over to one side every now and then. Oh, that's not a door. Is this the door? Well, here we go. Well, I don't know what I was expecting. What an earthly apparition is this? That's the correct term. Lucky you. You will live, I promise you. And why would you wander into a gloomy place like this one? You can see people have got nothing to do here. And yet you're stuck here for the same reason. Have you been here long? I'm doing a civic duty here. My name is the Harpist and I furnish the house of the living. Now I'm just watching. Look what happens when living matter comes into contact with these infectious miasma. I know very well what happens. Let's go. Lara is worried about you. See if I can take anything else from here whilst I'm up here. Oh, perhaps that would be dangerous. Oh dear. Yep, that would be dangerous. Whoop.
Going outside should be prohibited. Special courier should be assigned.
What are you doing here? You've just been at Anna's place. Or are there several of you? Go to hell, you and your jokes. Let's carry on our wayward track downwards, talk to the lad, go around and then talk to Grace and then circle back up. Doubling back is something I'd rather avoid. So let's try and just make all our trips productive ones. I think, given the nature of the reputation in Clara's game, which is constantly falling, and the plethora of bandits and easy prey out at night, easy, actually, just with the nature of how Clara can kill from a distance. Far easier than the horsebacks, at any rate. So that's quite nice.
Those lazy bastards go.
Hang on. Didn't you go down into the well? How did you get back up here so quickly? I've never been here before. And who's down the well and who's down there in the well? Why are you lying to me? No, your tricks aren't going to baffle me. I've, after all, read a lot about you. Creatures fashioned out of clay and bones. I know what's said about you in the Tale of the Daughters and in the Bow Omegas too. Oh, don't joke like that. I hereby solemnly declare that none of that refers to me.
Did you hear that? Did it come from inside the well? Or am I getting the jitters?
I'm beginning to like you. When I look at you, I get the strange feeling that you're the closest person I have in the world. It's like a spell. Could you tell me about Aspiti, then? You know who that is, right? How could I not? The most interesting person. So you've met her already. That was quick. What do you need her for? Alexander Savarov wants to find the criminal guilty of bringing about the calamities that are threatening you all. I'm acting on his behalf. Isn't it the other way around? Never mind, I'm just kidding. So he advised you to ask me? Crafty that, I've underestimated him. So essentially, he wants to do me a favor by getting this monster out of the way. She's a monster? She's the reason for all of the kin's riots and unrest. No one has ever harmed our family more. Sometimes I feel she is an evil spirit. She appeared suddenly after one of the riots. At the time, my father brutally crushed the revolting butchers, and it was then that he appointed Oyun as their foreman. Is that so? Yes, and ever since then I've thought of her as a personification of the kin's defiance. I've even begun to confuse cause and consequence. Did she appear to avenge our cruelty, or are her provocations forcing my father's hand? It's become a vicious cycle. So you believe she's an avenger? An embodiment of divine retribution? Isn't that too grand for her? No, I saw her just a little while ago. Can't forget her eyes. Languid, but also very keen in intent. Sardonic. Before that, she used to act as if I didn't exist. She preferred to curse my father, threatening to ruin him. It's all really very strange. What's so strange about it? You know what just occurred to me? She's already taken care of my father. What do you mean? Exactly that, yes. Yes, there's a reason things have been going the way they have. All that horrible thing at the cemetery, yes. She's aimed a battering ram at him that will strike him down any time now. Now she's shifted her attention to me. That's what's happening. Should I warn him? I don't like this, but he's angry at me. Yes, it would do good to speak to him. That's where I can find a hook.
Haruspex did have the guts to accept his heritage in the end.
You were found in the earth, pulled out of a grave. So you're saying that you've made your way out of the steppe and can't remember anything now? Then I have no doubt that you're the Shabnakadir. I've studied the legends quite thoroughly. How can I prove that I'm human? It was a joke, obviously. Do you seriously think I would interpret mythical figures literally? That said, there's definitely something obscure about you. I can't get rid of an annoying feeling that as I stand here looking into your eyes, you're simultaneously staring at the back of my head. Because I'm an unusual kind of girl. This must be a bad time for me to turn up, right? On this threat of plague epidemic we're facing. Do you know anything about it? An epidemic? No, I know nothing about it. By the way, since you're such a master of good deeds, would you like to do something very beneficial? Why not? Do tell me. Then listen. Due to the threat of epidemic, our town's ruling families have divided certain burdensome duties among themselves. Bachelor Denkovsky has asked our family to take care of setting up special facilities as well as commandeering medical supplies. A wise decision? You think? Well, perhaps. So the thing is, the town's short on medicine. We're scraping together what little we can, but there's a certain someone who's been stockpiling various drugs for 5 years now. A young singer named Anna Angel. Oh, yes. All that medicine will be of no use to her. I don't want to force her to surrender it. After all, with the kind of relationship that we have, I can't afford to be rude or intimidating. You seem capable of being very persuasive. So please persuade Anna to donate her stockpile. Voluntarily. She doesn't need that much anyway. It's more like compulsive hoarding at this point. I'll certainly manage that. You just have to look a person in the eye and they become so docile. I'm a mellower of hardened hearts. Well. So, we have a few different ways we can go here then. Ugh, this key is really getting very annoying. It's the strafe right key is very much sticking and it's becoming a real nuisance. Anyway. Perhaps I should just go quickly and talk to Vlad the Elder first. Might be a little bit less doubling back. And it is usually helpful not to double back in this game if you can avoid it. So I'm going to try and avoid buying food, because generally speaking on the second day there's enough panic that food costs significantly more. This is not going to go well. Right.
I can't breathe. Not enough air.
Wrong door, girl. Victoria lives in the other wing of the house. I'm Clara. What is this place? Clara, this house is called The Lump, but I am Vlad Olgimsky. What, does thy name ring no bells at all? Your man is telling me that you're a person of influence. Your voice, that you're very unhappy.
Fortune turns all.
What's this now? So skinny. I've come to... Obesity often causes heart failure, if you get my drift. So come to warn you, you're in danger. What? Who sent you? Was it Yaklach? Yaklach? Who's that? Anyone in the hallway? Take this thing away. You're in danger. Aspidi's set up a trap for you. You don't have to. I don't have to, but... I know who you are. You're the Saber of Foundling. Move along. Foundling? What? A spitty. I'd crush her with a single stare if I ever deigned worthy of her. Blech. If I ever deigned her worthy of my notice. Crush her? Go ahead and try. So it's money you want, you little informer. I can appreciate that. I really can. So take this for saving my life. I'll have a better look at her then. Your head's just like your belly, all fat and no brain. I don't need your money. No. That's better. You'll appreciate me yet. Hey, sweet money. I mean, I don't really think that got me any new hooks, but... Okay, if we go this way, that's probably the quickest. All these good deeds done, and it's not even 3:30. Cutting around the ear and around the back is the quickest way, I think. Whoa, whoa, what? Come from. That's a lot of money we got.
Shabnaka deer is tracing the streets like bacteria in a vein.
Hey, for a moment there I thought I was suddenly in front of a mirror. You have the same bottomless eyes as me. That's because you and I are flesh of the same mother's flesh. Who is she, this mother of ours? The Earth. And who are you? I call myself Sabna Otun. Children of Bodo call me Saba Usptai. The locals here have already corrupted to a spitty. What's your name? So, you're not who I almost thought you were. My name's Clara, but you can call me the Harbinger. Clara, huh? Doesn't ring true. The name would better suit some holy martyr than a spawn of deities ingrown in time. I'm not the spawn of evil. If that's the price of your kinship, no. I'll pay no mind to your words. You're playing with me.
What are the Architect Brothers up to? Escaping the town? Made a mess and chickened out?
You are insistent. Pushy, even. If you're disowning our kinship, then why the friendly look? Aspiti, oh Aspiti, I know of you this. Clara, darling, have you gone mental? Must be the local air. Happens to outsiders a lot. I'm no Aspiti. Saba Otun. Look, that's enough. You're being obnoxious. Are you trying to bewitch me? Would you like to see me try that too? The way I do it with creatures like your little self? Careful, Clara, my child. You may go missing. Don't be cross. I just want to talk.
Yes.
I need to talk to you. To confide in you, if you like. I don't trust you. Why bother to talk, huh? We'd be better off together than each on our own. Quite the contrary, we'd be much better off on our own than together. Would you perhaps like me to do something for you? What could I do to warm you up to me? Listen here, nimble darling, if you really want to have a nice conversation with me, then bring me Burak. Know who that is? I see you do. You can't leave my house now, and he needs me badly. Uh-oh. You moron, it's not what you think. It's about his life and his duty. I'm worried. He's being hunted. If you find him, tell him I've got the key to his destiny. He ought to hurry. Time is of the essence. If he's in doubt, whisper one word to him. Inheritance. Fine, I'll do the whisper. But if I do find him, you owe me that conversation. Right. Burak's lodgings are here, Grace's lodgings are there. Let's go to Grace's first.
Is looking for a silent house. Are you sure you are safe?
Do you hear the metal things clinking on my chest? Those aren't keys or lockpicks. They're a special kind of hook. Look what I brought you, Grace. Oh, flowers. So beautiful, too. Thank you. How did you know? Those are exactly the ones I wanted to offer Farkad. He likes the color red. Perhaps you're fond of them, too? I am, Grace, and I'm fond of you, too. Is there anything I could do for you? I'd be glad to, because just yesterday, as I was looking at you, I thought I'd like to give you a hug. Grace, oh Grace, I know of you this. No. Do you really trust me just like that? Will you agree to talk to me? I trust you as I trust myself. I'm all ears, dear sister. Are you afraid, Grace? Very, very much so. What's going to happen to us, Grace? There will soon be a plague. Why is this happening to us? because there's no escaping it now. It's been coming to us from the steppe, getting closer step by step. The dead felt her coming. She pierced the earth with her sharp bone stilts, which reached them from the ground. No one will be spared. Do you know why it happened? No, but I'm afraid it's the punishment for our sins, for all our faults and transgressions. Someone among us has angered the heavenly powers. It was bound to happen with us being so brazen, so says Lady Katharina. Exactly. I'm glad that your faith is firm. I promise you that as long as you can muster the strength to accept the divine will, nothing will hurt you. Well, just gonna go old Joan of Arc here and get people to believe me and trust me unwaveringly by performing bizarre little miracles, which probably aren't really miracles. Yeah, that'll do. What's your business here? Aspity claims she's holding the key to your destiny. You should go and see her.
Who's Aspity?
So you don't know. She's a woman living on the kip at the edge of the earth. Some people call her place a hospice.
Huh. An excellent recommendation.
Nevertheless, I believed her at once.
I'll visit this woman of yours. Show me where she lives.
It's the only house with the cellar in the quarter, with which corners on the abattoir and runs adjacent to the cemetery.
And thus we tell the bachelor of his inheritance. Bachelor, the higher respects of his inheritance. Beginning the very, very long trials of Artemy. The culture of the steppe is a very interesting one, and the way it's portrayed in the game, I think, is very interesting. An unusual culture which is not really very much known to Western audiences. I've told him. He will come.
He's been here already. What did you want to talk about? Ask quickly. Are you sleepy? Why are you lowering your eyes?
No, I'm not. Speak.
Saba Otun, oh Saba Otun, I know of you this. You've fallen in love with this Burak. Do you agree to touch me, to brave the depths? Answer my questions candidly and without prejudice.
What do you want to know?
Who are you?
I was born 5 years ago during the first outbreak. I'm a reminder.
Are you the plague personified?
I could be, but I haven't done anything recently. Though I did organize that riot which got the infected Isidore in a bit of a pickle.
Shabnak Adir exists? Is it you?
Which of us is the reason for everything? Which of us is a figurine with a clot of a living soul residing in her, but for a while? Which of us is the true Shabnak Adir? You'll see in the end. I'll be of service to you yet, Changeling. Spare me, or don't let your sister out. Don't let her take over.
Why do you call me that?
That is your greatest blessing. You're a thief now.
having stolen the name and the fate of another. Beware of the law. You'll live through your persecution and emergent triumphant, maybe. I'll think it over. So, here we go. Reassuring. Right. Let's go to Anna Angel's place then. Yes, I think that's definitely the most sensible next move. Oof, this sticky key is very, very frustrating. Anyway, I find the step culture interesting, mainly because it is something that we don't really know of in the West, and even within Russia, I don't think it's exactly a very well-known thing in the Western parts, as far as I understand it. I could be wrong. I don't want to be an authoritative voice on something that I'm not an authority in, but I think that's part of the reason that the game's setting is as interesting as it is. It is the borderland between the culture of, I suppose, Mongolia, really, and the steppe, and the Far East meeting the much more westernized lands of Russia. Hence all these legends.
Olgimsky is buying up whatever medicine there is. I wonder why.
The Olgim... Why are your eyes like that? As though you were going to eat me. The
Olgimskys
have been ordered to commandeer all medicine, Anna. I see you have a lot of every variety. Is it true? No, I don't have any medicine. When I was young, I used to play at the house of the Wicked Witch. Now that's who had a real stash for every disease. She lived for 100 years. The place had that pharmacy smell everywhere. Do you take me for someone like that crone? Nonsense. Don't lie to me, Anna. I even know where you keep it. Why are you trying to deceive me? Oh, what a pain. This is surely a plot against me. They want to kill me, destroy my life, send me to an early grave. An early grave, yes. Listen, I don't want some disease to eat me alive, to ruin my skin. Leave me that, if nothing else, or just shoot me with a gun. Give them at least some of it. Save the best-looking ones for yourself. I think that's a good idea, isn't it? Look here. Leave me alone, my dear, and I will show my gratitude. I have means too, don't you know? I will tell you another thing. That Ripper, the one from yesterday, the Olgimskys have given him shelter. So the thing is, they don't have to snatch medicine from the people. He knows how to make his own. Really? Common folk are gossiping about it already. His father knew the secret, and he, the Ripper, has been concealing his art from Vlad, because there's a mystery involved, and he needs blood. He probably guessed that Olgimsky would make him work to return the favor. I wish he did just that. Just show this mixture to Vlad, and he'll have that man chained to the walls by his leg at once. How can someone like that be put in chains? I can see that you're really sticking together in here. I have no reason to like this murderer. Find out if it's true. If it is, give Vlad the hint and he'll have him get down to business. Then we can get rid of that horrible Haruspex. May he curl up and die beside his Albinik. Just make sure to find out if he can or he can't. You need to be certain. Alright, but how? He's already prepared several concoctions. That's what the herb bride says. You know, the naked one, that swarthy local girl who always gathers herbs in the steppe. You know her? She belongs to one of the gatherers. He warms the earth for her. Let's inquire, shall we? Alright, we'll do it your way, but you owe me one. So. Back out we go. I'm just going to clear up these couple of quests of the day first. And that'll get the Sabarovs off my back for a little while.
Oh dear. Once more, I'm trying to demonstrate and showcase this game immediately post night shift, so I apologize if my mannerisms are a little bit lacking. Or otherwise tired and exhausted. I thought I'd try and simulate what these characters are going through to the best of my ability.
My strength will complement her weakness. It's time for our family to shine.
Exploit with Aspiti. I got inside her soul. I never doubted you would. What is in there? I couldn't decide, but I did feel our souls had something in common. What is your verdict then? Is she guilty? No, she isn't. Not good, so there's been no miracle. Are you angry, Father? On the other hand, I would have suspected that it would be impossible to pinpoint the culprit at once. That tips the scale a little more against your twin sister. Aware, Clara, your reputation has taken a serious blow. The rabble does not distinguish between the two of you. All the same, she's not guilty. That's a pretty minor reputation hit.
Yes.
And whilst I can defend myself, I'm less sure that Aspiti could. And Aspiti is one of my adherents.
You'll have to withstand trials. We need to hurry.
I've spoken to Grace. And so, she believes and thinks the same way as we do. That's good. You have not, I hope, confused or disappointed her. No, I've only made her truth faith firmer. Well. That makes things a little bit easier. Yep. Today's quest and that quest are now done. Right, let's nip across to Lara's and then across to the herb gatherers. That finishes most of our quests. After that, I'm going to try and just sleep through most of the remainder of the day. If I'm asleep, then my reputation doesn't go down. But, I haven't filled up my last remaining water bottle. There we go. Did I actually save someone? Yes, I did. Go me. I'm actually doing something right. I still haven't filled up my water bottles. I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, goodness. Oh, God. Nope, he's after me now. So is the harpist back? Yes, in that house. I take it is really infected. It is infected, Lara. You're gonna have to set up your shelter here. Here, this is for your help. Take it. I won't need it anymore. So much? Thank you.
Sweet. More cash. Which is going to undoubtedly come in handy. Oh, I'm oddly rich as Clara. That's an unusual state of affairs. Generally speaking, as Clara, I find it's more useful to take reputation over money, just because of the nature of Clara's reputation loss constantly going, well, constantly losing. So, as such, it's often better to accept boosts in your reputation where you can. However, my reputation's fucking great. Which is great. And it's all because of these bandits. Who I've been a lot less reluctant to kill. There's a one shot that you can do. I never quite manage it. Where you just sneak up behind them and break their neck. Ooh, sweet bandages. Yes, there is a one shot stealth kill that you can do where you walk up and sneak behind them and break their neck. But I've never been able to quite get it right. As has been evidenced every time that I've done it. Oh well. Still, 13,000 rubles. I'm not sure if the currency used at this point in the game is actually rubles, but I'm going to call them rubles for the sake of ease. The time in which this game is set now, I know that I have made reference to it before being confusing and anachronistic. However, I think that is something that also reflects what was going on within Russian history at when I estimate this time to be, which is, say, roughly the early 1900s. This is a period of time in which mechanization and increase of heavy industry was just becoming a thing in Russia, but as some of my watchers may know, Russian history is, well, fascinating, but also has a lot of these moments of I suppose conflict between urbanization and mechanization and tradition. Due to the sheer size of Russia and the vastness and untamed nature of a huge proportion of its lands, it wasn't exactly the same quick industrialization process and easy agriculture that we had in the West. Indeed, a good deal of Russia's agriculture came out of communally owned farms, which were arguably very inefficient, arguably incredibly inefficient, which served in many ways to keep the serf population under control. The serf population, which essentially functioned quite like feudal peasantry. Now, I'm aware that they weren't. There are some important differences, but for the purposes of this argument, they are very, very similar to medieval peasantry. Which leads, in my opinion, to the odd anachronisms of time that we have here with the medieval outlooks, the medieval viewpoints, the medieval yurts and step culture, which are coming into conflict with the modernization of the city.
Has a big man come to you? Sinewy arms, apt to violence. Harrispex is his name.
There's more than one Harrispex here, more than one that knows. Which of them do you need? The biggest and the most dangerous is former No-Yun. He came here 2 days ago, trampled our fires and yurts. We would have died under his hooves had we not hidden ourselves.
No, I've no desire to meet a monster like that. I need a stranger, one of the outsiders.
Is it Burak? You need Burak, not the old, the young one.
Yes, he came here. Did he bring his herb formulas?
He did. I didn't take them. He took them to the dealers, took to sell to the dealers.
Who are the dealers?
Herb dealers are all in the den. A cruel man reigns there, an artist, a builder, the one who also came from the other end of the steppe, the end where only the dressed up dead and Suok spawn dwell. He makes his taurine tinctures there. He blasphemes, he abuses the herb.
How does he blaspheme against it?
He treats herbs badly, he tries their patience, gives more money for them than we do. He sets us against each other, made us kill those who'd given him the secret spices. If you ever find herbs, don't give them to him. He'll hurt them.
Do you want me to sell them to you?
No business shall be had with you, for you smell of clay. Don't you ever come back here, for you smell of rich, clotted clay.
Gross.
Well, he's not giving any useful information, but he did effectively tell me that the Stamerson brothers are going to sell me, or will buy Twire from me for a lot of money. So that's useful, at least.
So yes, my fairly amateur analysis of 19th century Russian culture.
Now, I also emphasize that my analysis is very, very amateurish. I am primarily a scientist rather than a historian, but I would like to think that I have some mild understanding of the of things that I've researched. My understanding is that that a lot of the anachronisms reflect that are presented in the game are quite reflective of I suppose the changing times in Russian history. Jesus. It really does annoy me how much damage those knives do when thrown. Because it's insane. It nearly one-shots you. If you aren't on completely full health, you will be one-shotted by them. Which feels a little bit cheap. Of the second day has come. Infected 21, died 11, missing 7, death toll 22, currently infected 23. Which the changeling discovers are just judge skills, simultaneously converting into the true faith. Oh wow. Yep, I'm selling the knives. Because I don't need them, I can't use those knives. That's quite good. I might buy actually some
small trading gear whilst I'm here then. Don't need morphine though. Turin. I'll buy some Turin. Do I want to buy Turin? Yes. Why not? Two will do. No, I don't want... Actually, no. I'm going to be indecisive. I'm not going to buy it today. I will buy it tomorrow when the prices return back to normal.
I have my share of dancing. The curtain falls.
Am I seeing double? I thought there was only one pair of twins within this town.
Could be. And who are they?
My brother and I. So you've seen me before?
The prices are rising fivefold every hour. What a laugh. I'd stock up on bars of soap if I wasn't too lazy for that.
So what are you doing in this opium den? Want some hashish? Or are you waiting for the step diva to fall into another of her trances and throw off the last of her rags? Are you even 12 yet? Did the Irispec sell you any of his Turin infusions? Wow. Heaven's angel here knows her control substances, go figure. Yes, he did sell me some. Why are you asking?
Olginsky was asking.
That old shock. Right, so if Vlad finds out that his cutthroat is learned to mix herbs, the guy's in for it. Vlad's the wholesaler's already got, what, 8,000 indentured servants? What's one more? Ouch. It's up to you if I should rat him out to Vlad. The Irispec will be useful to you, so don't cross him. He'll figure out who the snitch was right away. I can sell some immune system boosters, but they'll cost you.
Show me.
Ten what? Oh, wow. He wants a lot. Yeah, I don't. Well, I guess I should probably go back to Vlad the Younger then. Screw it. I'm gonna go and just take stock from Anna. I'm not gonna give in Barak, given how useful he is. I don't know if I necessarily want to give an angel completely, but she's not really trustworthy. Not necessarily very useful.
Life is hard.
Anna, I'm back. The Olginskys are waiting. Give me the medicine. It won't help you anyway. How can you know they won't help? Pray, Anna. You're looking for salvation in the wrong place. Place. Fuck. Right. That'll do. Small selection of alpha and beta tablets and not really gonna save anyone's life here really that significantly. Right. I'd rather Barak was able to create more panacea. Perhaps this is biased from having played Barak most recently, but I would like him to be able to do what he needs to do. This is the quickest
quicker way would be worth going down this way rather than going through the warehouses. Reputation's still at full, which is good. Oh. Thought I could make a shortcut. That was a bad decision.
Don't tell me that's not what you were expecting.
I talked to Anna. So you're saying that she's been stockpiling medicine for 5 years, awaiting the second coming of that plague?
That's right. Curious now, are you? No, Anna's not someone to suspect of starting the outbreak. Did she give her pistache?
Like she had a choice, of course she did.
How did you manage that?
Explain to her that none of it would help anyway.
Is that true?
I don't know, but it does feel that way. Why have you suddenly turned so pale?
Well, I think I finally know who's standing before me, torn once again. My heart is begging me to offer you everlasting friendship, whilst my head would rather have me stay away from you.
Don't worry, your words won't change anything. There's no one closer to you than me. Remember that.
See how. I think we just need to sleep the rest of the day. Which isn't a very interesting way to spend most of the day, but at least it stops the reputation getting completely wiped. Oof. Rations are going to become a problem. Okay, we're at 8-ish. Right, here we go. Okay. Are you a saint or a thief, since they call you both names? Whether or not you're a saint is not for you to judge, but can you at least remember what it was you stole? Why do they try to chase you, to hunt you down as if you were the world's worst offender? Sister of mine, don't you cry, don't give in to despair. As powerful as your enemies are, your protectors wield greater power. A villain should be judged, a saint should perform miracles. If you can't spare time for these everyday commitments, rest assured I will take care of your affairs for you. I'm going to visit the Skinner's district today. Do you recognize my hand yet? Who's he attacking? That's gonna be tough. There we go. Go, that's good. Oh, there's one in the theater. Oh. There we go. Oh. Not quite time to open it up yet. Right, that's fine. If I can go down there already. No, I can't. Oh well, it was worth a try. I wonder if there's any more bandits to kill. Well, would you look at that? Yes, there is. Where is it gonna go? Nope, now he spotted me. To get me something to just ease off the pain before I sleep. I also need to get more rations because I'm not looking very good. But I also can't really afford to throw all of that money down the drain. Which I definitely would do if I bought items today. I have to wait until tomorrow. Isn't that a bummer? Oh well. Well, might as well just hang out outside the front of the house. And wait for the dawn to arrive. The building actually quite reminds me of the House of Actors, which is a building in Kiev.
Your timely efforts allowed your supporters to remain unharmed. A new mime performance is being rehearsed at the theater.
Here we go.
Rulu had to accept something was wrong. The terrifying discoveries have convinced them.
One of them managed to curb the family feud.
Bad news. The governor will abuse his power, and the rest won't let him get away with this. Nothing's changed.
The town was placed in quarantine. From now on, the infected districts will be locked down, and no one will be able to leave until the situation is resolved.
Well, it won't be. They won't figure it out.
So, there you have it. Well, we'll see you next time.